Good afternoon again, and welcome back to St Mary's Church in Newmarket. Firstly, my apologies that there hasn't been much put up here on the channel recently. We've been in the midst of ordinary time, a season of busyness, and there's been plenty going on. But I thought I'd return to the channel on this, the week of the Feast of the Transfiguration, which is a particularly important feast in the midst of ordinary time. I'm here in front of the window of the Transfiguration, which tells the story of Christ up on the Mount, traditionally identified as Mount Tabor, and on his left and right are Moses, bearing the tablets with the Ten Commandments, and the prophet Elijah, both of whom it is prophesied would return at the coming of the age. With him are Peter and James and John, the disciples whom he named, whom he chose to come up and witness this event with him. He chose only those three, as is told in the Gospels, because he wanted this to be an event of significance, but an event that would be revealed over time. So it was important that he had those witnesses, but only those few witnesses who were privileged to see that at the time. What this feast means for us, it's made clear in the text for the day, is it's a day to remember that ministry that we've been participating in, that ministry of us one to another, is born in the body and the being of Christ. And by our participation in Christ's activity, that sanctifies our human activity, just as Christ became flesh and dwelt and lived alongside us. So in the Transfiguration, when we see our humanity in Christ born and in Christ's person, the glory of the Father made known, so that recognises that what we do here on earth has the possibility of being taken up into that glory. So it's a day when our ministry is recognised for what it is. It doesn't change our ministry, but in this central feast of ordinary time, it marks that what began as a very earthly event, the Spirit filling those disciples who were taught to go out and spread the good news, that ministry is on a trajectory towards All Saints, towards the kingdom season, when we will recognise its possibility of its fulfilment in the kingdom of heaven. The other thing emphasised in the texts for the day is that this is a feast for all the nations. It's a feast when we remember that we all have that invitation to be part of the body of Christ, and we all have the possibility of being transfigured to reveal the glory of the kingdom of heaven. And so while we have Elijah and Moses who look back to the promises made to the people of Israel, in Christ who comes where there is no Jew or Greek, there is no slave or free, there is no male or female, Christ teaches that those promises are made available to all humankind. There may be different ways of accessing those promises, but we believe it is through Christ that we come to the glory of the Father. Let us pray. Father in heaven, whose Son, Jesus Christ, was wonderfully transfigured before chosen witnesses upon the holy mountain, and spoke of the exodus he would accomplish at Jerusalem, give us strength so to hear his voice and bear our cross, that in the world to come we may see him as he is, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The Lord be with you. Christ Jesus, the splendour of the Father and the image of his being, draw you to himself, that you may live in his light and share his glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you now and always. Amen.